13 years after the beginning of his prophetic mission, the Holy Prophet, after being invited by the people, left Mecca for Medina. Immediately after entering Medina, the Holy Prophet began to create treaties, firstly between the tribes of Medina and then between these tribes and the Jews. These treaties were accepted and signed by all parties. Muslims and Jews will live in Medina as a single nation. The Muslims and Jews can practice their respective religions freely. At a time of war, they will assist one another on the condition that the other is not the oppressor. If Medina is attacked, both parties will rise to defend it. Any treaty with an enemy has to be done with the other's permission. Medina is a holy and virtuous city, so no blood should be shed in it. The signatories of this treaty should treat each other with respect and dignity. However, all the Jewish tribes of Medina in one way or another broke the treaties and on many occasions acted treacherously towards the Muslims and the Holy Prophet. They drew up plans to kill the Holy Prophet. They joined forces and assisted the unbelievers against the Holy Prophet. At times, they would go to Mecca and invite the Quraysh to fight against the Holy Prophet. They also themselves used to fight against the Holy Prophet. Despite all these plans and treacheries, the Holy Prophet never sought revenge and took the most lenient of decisions against them, decisions that even the Jews were pleased with them. For example, they would be exiled from Medina without anybody being killed, or only that person who performed the crime would be punished.
در 100 کیلومتری شمال مدینه سرزمینی به نام فدک که نام خودش رو از اولین ساکن اون سرزمین به نام فدک ابن هام گرفته وجود داشت که تا امروز هم باقی است.
اولین کسی که در فدک زندگی می کرده فردی یهودی بوده به نام فدک ابن هام. برای همین هم اسم این منطقه رو گذاشتن فدک، به اسم همین کسی که اولین نفر اینجا سکونت می کرده. ناگفته نماند وقتی که این منطقه به دست امیر المومنین و حضرت رسول صلوات الله و سلامه علیهما فتح شد، کسی که اینجا مسئول بود، فرمانده بود و بزرگ و حکمران و حکمران این منطقه بود، فردی یهودی به نام یوشع ابن نون.
The people of Fadak, after hearing about the fall of Kaibar at the hands of Amir al-Mu'minin Imam Ali, out of fright sought refuge in their fort. They bolted down the doors and passed the night away in worry and distress, as they had been treacherous to the Holy Prophet and the treaties as they gave refuge to those Jews who fled Khaybar after fighting the Holy Prophet.
پس از فتح خیبر وحی رسید از طرف پروردگار به رسول خدا صلی الله علیه و آله و سلم که یهودیان منطقه فدک هم نقشه کشیدن برای ضربه زدن به اسلام. حضرت رسول و امیرالمومنین علی علیه الصلاه و السلام شبانه آمدند به سمت فدک.
So Amir al-Mu'minin Imam Ali got onto the shoulders of the Holy Prophet and was lifted up, and by the help of Allah, Imam Ali climbed to the top of the wall and once up there recited the azan and takbir in a loud voice. The people of Fadak thought that the Muslims had climbed over the walls of the fort, fled towards the gate of the fort, opened it, and dispersed into the fields. The Jews of Fadak pleaded with the Holy Prophet to spare their lives and to give them back half their property. The Holy Prophet accepted this request and sent Amir al-Mu'minin Imam Ali with the guarantee of their safety and compromise with them. This treaty between the Holy Prophet and the Jews of Fadak was signed and given to them as a reminder to act upon it.
این در مورد جان و مالهای شخصی این افراد بود. اما خود فدک ملک شخصی پیغمبر اکرم شد و بنا شد که درآمد اون رو که سالانه 120 هزار سکه طلا بود برای پیغمبر اکرم ارسال کنه.
Fadak becoming the personal property of the Holy Prophet is coherent with the clear ruling in the Holy Quran, as this land was captured without any military activity.
قرآن کریم می‌فرماید که فما افاء الله علی رسوله من اهل القرى فلله وللرسول ولذی القربى. تا آنجا که می‌فرماید فما اوجفتم علیه من خیل و لارکاب فان الله یسلط رسله علی من یشاء.
این آیات نشون میدن طبق سوره مبارکه 8 آیه 6 و 7 سرزمین های فی به دست رسول خدا بوده و رسول خدا اینو قرار میداد یا برای نزدیکانشون و یا برای مسلمان ها.
The Holy Prophet asked Jabrail who this person was and what should he give them. Jabrail brought the answer from Allah saying, give Fadak to Fatima.
حضرت رسول امیرالمومنین علی علیه السلام رو طلبید و گفت یا علی مطالبی که میگم شما بنویس. بسم الله الرحمن الرحیم. من محمد ابن عبدالله به دستور خداوند متعال فدک رو هبه می کنم، هدیه میدم به زهرا دخترم. پیامبر به امیرالمومنین دستور داد که مردم رو در مسجد جمع بکنن. جمع شدن مردم و در آنجا پیامبر این دستور خداوند رو و این قباله فدک رو که نوشته شده بود برای مردم قرائت کردند و همه مردم هم شاهد بودند و دیدند.
The Holy Prophet called for a paper and called Hazrat Amir al-Mu'minin and then said, write the Fadak is a gift from the Prophet and confirm it. Hazrat Amir wrote it down and the Prophet himself and one of his wives named Ummah Yaman testified for that. At that moment, the Holy Prophet said, Ummah Yaman belongs to heaven. Then he gathered people in Fatima's house, and then he distributed the income of Fadak as Fatima's property, and in this way he meant to show people the possession of Fatima on Fadak. Hazrat Zahra put an agent in Fadak and recruited some employees for him who, after accounting and paying the expenses, should grant her the annual net profit.
Hazrat Zahra به پیغمبر اکرم عرض کردند که تا شما زنده هستید من نمیخواهم در فدک تصرفی داشته باشم، چرا که جان و مال ما در اختیار شماست. پیغمبر اکرم فرمودند که از این بیم دارم که بعد از من نااهلان فدک رو از شما بگیرند و نگذارند که شما مالک فدک بشید. لذا به امر پیغمبر اکرم در زمان خود رسول خدا حضرت زهرا سلام الله علیها در فدک تصرف کردند و امور او رو به دست گرفتند.
10 days after the Prophet died, Abu al-Bakr sent some of his hacks to Fadak's property and fired Fatima's agent and confiscated the property, and from that moment, they started to spend the income of Fadak for their reign, and they did not care about the history of that place, the God's order, and the document which was set in public and in the Prophet's presence. Right after Hazrat Fatima was informed of what has happened, she wanted it back. She said that the Prophet granted her Fadak, and everyone knows it, and they have no right to take it. But Abu al-Bakr did not accept her word and asked for some witnesses, which means that Hazrat Zahra is a liar.
حضرت زهرا سلام الله علیها که جزء اهل بیتی هست که در سوره مبارکه احزاب آیه 33 به عنوان اهل بیت پیغمبر و به عنوان کسانی که خداوند رجس و پلیدی رو از آنها دور کرده و به عنوان معصومین قلم داد شدند. انما یرید الله لیذهب عنکم رجس اهل البیت و یطهرکم تطهیرا.
Despite all this, حضرت فاطمه called for some witnesses. Hazrat Ali, Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein, and Umayyah, the woman who was mentioned by the Holy Prophet as a heavenly woman. These witnesses and their testimonies were rejected by Abu al-Bakr for some vain reasons. After Abu al-Bakr refused to give back what he had taken, Hazrat Fatima tried a different way to argue with them, which was inheritance.
فدك بخشش و هبه بود نه ارث. حضرت زهرا سلام الله علیها آیاتی از قرآن را خواندند که اگر کسی از دنیا برود اموال او به ورثه او به ارث میرسد. پس اگر فدك نهله هم نبوده و هدیه هم نبوده، بعد از رحلت رسول خدا قاعدتاً بر طبق قرآن باید به ارث به حضرت زهرا سلام الله علیها برسه.
نقشه غصب فدك از پیش کشیده شده بود و برای اثبات این ادعای خودشون حدیثی رو جعل کرده بودند که گفتن ما از رسول خدا صلی الله علیه و آله و سلم شنیدیم که حضرتشون فرمودن نحن معاشر الانبیا لا نورث او لا نورث ما ترکناه صدقه، ما پیغمبرها از خودمون ارث باقی نمیگذاریم، آنچه هم میمونه باید به عنوان صدقه بین مسلمونها تقسیم بشه.
But she was the main interpreter of Quran, and as an answer for these fake hadiths, she read some of the Quran's verses. The verses which clearly showed that prophets leave inheritance just like others.
تازه حضرت زهرا سلام الله علیها فریاد زدن که آیا تو از پدرت ارث میبری؟ من از پدرم ارث نمیبرم. و حضرت سلیمان از باباش داوود ارث برد و ورث سلیمان و داوود. حضرت داوود برای فرزندش سلیمان ارث گذاشته بود، من به عنوان دختر پیغمبر ارث نمیبرم.
In addition to what was mentioned, the caliphs acted in some ways themselves, which proved the fakeness of that hadith.
زنان پیغمبر اکرم هم ادعای ارث کردن و درخواست ارث داشتن و ارث به اینها داده شد و در اون هنگام کسی سخنی از این حدیث به میان نیاورد.
All reasons which was brought up by Hazrat Fatima were rejected by Abu al-Bakr. Until one day Hazrat Ali told her, "You should talk to Abu al-Bakr out of it when Umar is not around him." Hazrat Zahra went to Abu al-Bakr while she had her 6-year-old son Imam Hassan with herself, and talk to Abu al-Bakr. She said to him, "You claim my father's status and you sit where he used to sit? Even if Fadak had been your property and I would have asked you to give it to me, you should do that." Abu al-Bakr said, "Yes, you are right." And then he passed the FedEx document to her. Hazrat Fatima went out and she was heading to home that she ran into Umar on her way. And that was the moment that the tragedy happened. History is speaking loudly, but just a person who really wants to hear it can understand its depths. Remember that just because sometimes we find sad facts in history, that does not mean we should not go for it. History is history. It makes us think and observe deeper. Go for it. Digging out the truth makes you feel better.